So this is Covent Garden tube station on the Piccadilly Line, right in the heart of London, in Zone 1. And this way
is Leicester Square tube station, just one stop down the line.
Now, it's a well-known fact,
hi,
that the shortest distance between any two tube stations on the tube network is the classic Covent Garden to Leicester Square. It's the shortest journey you can make.
It's also the most expensive for the distance, which is just 270 metres between the two stations.
Charing Cross to Embankment on the Northern Line comes a very close second, but the trip between Leicester Square and Covent Garden really is the shortest, taking just half a minute from the moment the train sets off to the moment that it stops again.
But what I want to know is, I don't think, maybe apart from some poor tourists that don't know any better, nobody really gets on at Leicester Square and goes one stop to Covent Garden, do they?
True.
Don't do that. More likely, people do it as part of their integrated journey, if you're a commuter or you work at Covent Garden.
Because if you're on the Piccadilly Line already,
it makes sense to go to Covent Garden.
To stay, yes.
However, what if you're travelling on the Northern Line? And that's what I want to test today.
Right,
okay. So if you're coming down the Northern Line, is it quicker to get out at Leicester Square and walk just a few seconds down the Longacre?
So, or go up the escalators, up the stairs,
Or is it longer, as I think it is, to change at Leicester Square? You've got to walk the steps in the corridor, wait for a train at Covent Garden, the lift or the stairs. Mm-hmm. Surely that takes longer than just coming out on the escalator.
Okay.
Especially if you walk up the escalator at Leicester Square. So, as a test, we're going to do it three times. That's six. Then we're going to do it three times.
I'll hold two, you hold one. Three times.
And we agreed already that I'm going
to... You're going to get the train, you're going to change trains.
And you're going to...
I'm going to walk.
Time ourselves, but generally it'll just be like, who gets to Covent Garden first?
Where are we going
to
meet?
Outside Covent Garden tube station.
Okay.
See you there? Oh no, we've got to go down to...
that was my cue for you.
Yeah.
To cut to the thing.
Let's do it from...
Hold on.
Tottenham Court Road. So I'm going to start my watch, so when the train moves.
So not when the door's closed?
Not when the door's closed, when it moves. We change in Leicester Square.
Yeah.
You take the street.
Yeah.
I go on the Piccadilly.
Yeah.
See you outside Covent Garden.
Yes.
See who gets there first.
At our designated
meeting spot.
Nice t-shirt.
Thank you very much. I want to live forever. Remember my name.
The next train is Leicester Square.
I'm on to the Piccadilly platform where there's a train approaching, so I haven't had to wait. So that's fortuitous that a train has arrived fairly quickly.
Just left the tube, time is 2:50. There's a lot of stairs.
I still think Vicky will win though. We'll see. We'll see. Also, we're going to time this one just the first time round. Every time we'll time it.
So we've got a green man, so I don't need to wait at the crossing. We're now headed to Longacre.
You can see there how ridiculously short it is. And now I've got to head for the lifts.
It's quite quiet on the Longacre today. So not many people, which has given me a good clear run. Walk, not running.
The stairs that station are 193 steps, which is the equivalent to a 15-storey building.
So there's the tube. This is our designated meeting spot. The time is 5:50. What?
And stopping at 5:55.
I got 5:50.
So you beat me by 5 seconds?
Yes.
But a train did come almost straight away.
You have to wait.
I had to wait about 10, 20 seconds. Already I can sense this is going to be
quite tight.
But basically, if a train turns up straight away, then you're tied, aren't you?
Yeah.
But if you have to wait for a Piccadilly Line train, walking's quicker. We'll do it 2 more times. That's the whole point of doing it 3 times, on average, to see, because I bet I don't get a train straight away next time.
Great, so I have to walk up the escalator again.
Again, yeah.
2 times.
Yeah. Should we go again?
Sure.
Back to Tottenham Court Road. Piccadilly.
So it's now 2:50, approaching the crossing.
Interesting, I can already hear the doors beeping, so I'm just missing a train right now.
Another green man, Dick.
Yeah, it's pulling out, so I've just missed one, which will mean a 2 or 3 minute wait for the next one.
And here we are on Longacre. I have to beat Jeff this time, surely.
Whoa, it's saying 4 minutes wait for the next one. So I'm definitely not gonna beat Vicky.
Okay. Let's just swap hands so that I can grab the phone. 5 minutes, 45 seconds. No Jeff. Still no Jeff. He must have really had to wait for a train.
I got here at 5:45. Because I had to wait four minutes for a train at...
I thought it might have something to do with the clock.
Nothing to do with the clock. If you have to wait for the train, you always lose. If the train comes straight away, you tie. So more often than not, you might as well walk. But let's do it one more time to Tottenham Court Road. Back at Tottenham Court Road, we'll wait for train number 3. Trip number 3.
Ready.
See you at Covent Garden. And then I guess we should do some kind of summing up.
It's really windy. Okay.
See you
later.
Again, did I just miss one, or was that the other side coming down the steps? What we got? Yeah, I just missed one. It's going off into the distance. Oh, but the next one is in 1 minute. So even though I just missed one, it shouldn't be more than a minute's wait which in London Underground minutes could be like 90 seconds. I think Vicky will still win.
Okay, we are at the destination. Stop. 6 minutes. Exactly. And no Jeff.
Change here. The Morgan Line. This is a Piccadilly Line service to
Got here at six minutes.
Bang
on.
I won. By a minute.
Yeah.
And I had to wait a minute for my train, which does rapidly help with my conclusion. Where should we go for our summing up in conclusion? Let's go over there. What do we conclude from that?
That it is quicker if you're travelling from the Northern Line and you need to get to Covent Garden, it is quicker to get out at Leicester Square if you walk up the escalator.
In my summary, if a train comes straight away or within a minute, then you time.
Yeah.
If you wait more than a minute. And really, the Piccadilly Line train will either come within sort of 0 to 1 minute, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, or 3 to 4 minutes. You shouldn't really have to wait longer than 4 minutes,
okay,
unless there's a specific delay or problem on the line.
Okay.
So if you take those four, 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, in like 75% of the cases, you will be slower than if you get out at Leicester Square.
Yeah.
And in 25% of the cases, 1 in 4, you will time.
Yes.
So it's never quicker to get the train one stop.
If you're changing from the Northern Line.
So always get out at Leicester Square and walk.
And it's good to walk.
It's good to walk. Helps Covent Garden become unclogged. Right. Amusingly, we have to go home on the Northern Line. Do you want to get the tube or do you want to walk to Leicester Square?
Please don't make me. Taxi.
Taxi. We'll get the tube.